West, Jim West, Desperado, Rough Rider, no you don't want nada.
Wow, wow, Wes.
Well, anyway, we're here live. Welcome to the podcast. We're here with Harry.
Wow, wow.
Yep.
Hello, Harold. Harold? Is it Harold?
Or Harry.
Just Harry.
Well, yeah. That's your government? Just no, right your government's Harold.
Government's Harold.
No, it's Harry.
You lie like a
rogue. You're born Harry?
I can show you my license.
Like the
Harry.
Prince?
Yeah.
Like Prince Harry?
Yeah, exactly like
you
that.
You are the prince of podcasting. The prince of comedy, Harold.
Take my hat off to do business, dude.
You just showed off your fucking cool hair, dude. It looks nice.
What, my haircut?
Yeah.
I didn't get a haircut.
No, but the way it's sitting from your hat looks nice.
Yeah, it's all slicked back.
I'm getting a buzz, dude.
Are you really?
Buzz.
You look good with the buzz.
Yeah, you do look good with a buzz.
Thank you, guys. I'm always worried about getting a buzz. I think it's off-putting.
I think you look good with it. I do like you with a mullet, though, too.
Yeah, but it became it was a spoof. And it was a cool haircut.
Yeah.
So it was like, I thought it was funny, but everyone was like, nice, cool haircut. And I was like,
yeah.
It's supposed to be a joke, but
do you
I'm like
buzz
12
yourself?
Years late. Huh?
Do you buzz it yourself or do you go somewhere?
I go somewhere.
Yeah, that's the way
I have a strict policy. Only women can cut my hair.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I don't let, including myself, I wouldn't let a man cut my hair.
Really?
I don't let men touch my head. I don't like it.
I've never even seen a male barber in New York.
There's a couple down the street.
Tommy cuts my hair.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, I just go downstairs. He's hammered. He's like, oh.
Took a chunk out. You're fine.
Yeah, I have nothing against
it. No, he
it.
Does a really good job.
Yeah, just...
He's a good hair cutter.
You're like a woman just scratching your head.
Yeah, her tits are right in your face the whole time.
You know what I mean? Why would you deny yourself that?
I don't know.
Why would you not do that if you have the option?
You'd have to be foolish.
You have some fucking old guy's glasses in your face. Like, tits. I'll take tits.
Tits.
I have the choice. Free will.
Yeah.
I'll determine my future.
That's one thing that was hard growing up. Is my sister's a hairdresser, and occasionally I'd get my hair cut in the kitchen. And when it's your sister's tits on your shoulder, it's
that makes sense.
A little bit like,
that's not as
playing safe.
This is disgusting.
True. Yeah. Like I'd rather go talk baseball
but
with a fucking
you do get
old
a
man.
Dude's dick on your elbow sometimes.
Oh, really?
Yeah. If you get a male hairdresser,
damn.
He comes around the side.
He must really lower your seat down.
Dick. Yeah, I'm tall.
Damn.
How many pounds of pressure would it take for you to be like, dude, get off?
I mean, you got to not move. You got to pretend it didn't happen.
Yeah, but like,
when the dick rubs against your arm, you got to go.
But what if you felt them go like, it's like you got to push.
Every once in a while, you get to lean in.
The chair's spinning. You're like, dude, get off me.
Yeah. Yeah. You got to lean in. You get a cock against the fucking upper
crazy.
Arm. Leaning across.
Never thought about that.
No, it's happened quite a bit.
Because
I would get Rick. Rick would cut my hair. Yeah. I almost never get a female haircut.
Yeah, well, that makes sense. Now that I think about it, my mom used to cut my hair when I was little.
Oh, me too.
When I was a little kid, my mom would cut my hair.
Yeah. Have you ever cut your own hair?
I might have tried to take the scissors. I don't really remember, but I think I must have cut it a little bit and was like, all right. Mom!
Yeah, I did the exact same thing.
I did something, I did something bad.
I remember there was an episode of Shameless where Lip cuts his own hair and then I cut my own hair and I fucked it up so bad.
You want to be like Lip?
Yeah, Lip was the man.
Lip's so
good. Who fucks Lip?
Lip from Shameless.
He's fucking all the hottest girls, the whole show.
Yeah, dude, he's addicted to alcohol, so he has to run everywhere he goes.
He's the
man.
But
he also smokes tons of cigarettes.
Sick.
Yeah, it's pretty, his sister's so fucking hot.
He's got
his
a hot sister?
Yeah, dude.
What's her name?
I don't know. The
Monica?
Older sister with the dark hair older sister.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is it Monica? No, not
no.
His mom's Monica. She's such a bitch.
Yeah, his mom sucks.
I've never seen it. I heard it was good.
It's pretty good.
It's good for the first few seasons.
Yeah, the first few seasons were
really
good.
Bad.
Then they got political.
Yeah, that's the only time I ever saw it. It was late, and it was very political.
Yeah.
Well, it's just because that redhead girl becomes the biggest bitch of all time.
She sucks.
She becomes the worst character in like all of TV.
Yeah, she stinks. She sucks. But, you know, yeah, they did. They got super political, and it was just like, yeah, if you think about it, people who are, like, super poor are actually the smartest ones. And you're like,
Yeah, well, turns out that is false. It's fiction. It was a team of writers. It was a lie. Yeah.
And it was the south side of Chicago, too, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
It's all yeah, that's what I know. It was white trash.
Wasn't it William H. Macy?
Yeah, he was pretty great in it.
He's the man.
He's awesome.
Yeah, he was pretty awesome in it. But yeah, it was like a bunch of like cool, poor white people in the south side of Chicago, which, again, been there.
They'd be having a negative experience.
I haven't seen them anywhere, dude. They're not there.
They are underground. They are afraid to come out.
They might have been mole people for
them. For sure. There's a whole, there's a lot of white people in the south side.
I've had people hit me up, like, I live on the south side, and they tell you where they live, and it's like, near the university. It's not the Wild Hunts, bro.
Yeah. Like,
see me on 87th Street, bro. See me on 103rd, bro.
Old block.
Don't talk to me about motherfucking 67th Street, dude. Come on.
Yeah, that's how it was with like West Philly. I'd be like, yeah, we live in West Philly. I'd be like, where? I'd be like, right next to Penn. Like University City, West Philly. Yeah.
Yeah, we live in between.
Although we were right on the border of where.
Yeah, dude.
Mantua.
We're in a forgotten bottom, bro.
It was tough. Oh, no. What's it called? I think it was called like the Underworld. Down Bottom.
It is. It's the forgotten bottoms, Grace, down outside of Grace Ferry. We're in the bottom. Like some lump informed me. He's like, you're actually in the underworld. And I was like, dude, why are you guys
Why
naming-
you guys live in Mortal Kombat levels?
Why are you naming that like that? Oh, shit. That's not the bottom. That's the underworld. I'm like, Jesus, man.
The Badlands, the underworld.
I prefer to call it Mantua.
It's Mantua. It's George Washington camped there. Anyway, Harold, what are you up to?
Not much.
What's your middle name?
Andrew.
Mother's maiden.
You guys love the royal, love the royal family.
Nah,
nice nod to Prince Andrew. All things aside, he was a good statesman.
Was he the pedophile one? Who's the pedophile?
He had a couple.
Andrew?
He had a couple slips.
Allegedly,
he might have been getting scientific funding, dude. We don't know.
He was the one whose whole claim to not being a pedophile was like, everyone knows I don't sweat. I'm incapable of sweating.
Yeah. He was like, that picture's not real. I don't sweat or something like that.
Yeah, because the girl said that he was soaked in sweat, and he was like, everyone knows I don't sweat.
Yeah, that's
a tough
one.
There's a picture of you and the girl.
He's drenched. He's got less sweat. Everyone knows I don't sweat.
I mean, it's like, what's more believable? A guy who's fucking kids and sweating all over the place, or he didn't fuck kids and doesn't sweat?
Or he never sweats.
Clearly, that's bullshit. And then he apologized. He's like, yeah, my bad. Like, that was the most.
I mean,
nobody was surprised, though. Everyone
think
like,
of his PR people during that interview. He's like, well, I don't sweat.
Oh, Jesus.
Fuck is he talking about? Fuck is he talking about?
Who the fuck doesn't sweat? Dude, everyone sweats.
You know how dogs can't sweat? They breathe out of their mouth real fast. That's what I do.
I drool.
Case closed. I don't fuck kids. I expel moisture through my mouth.
Speaking of scientific dorks, dude, you see Rogies body slam that dork?
Dude, did you see that guy's response? This actually was concerning when people were going like, anyone can debate. That doesn't mean you're right now. They're like,
oh, yeah.
And it's like, dude, okay, fair enough argument, but what's the point of science? Anything can be, you know, any study can be tweaked in a way. It's fucking bullshit. That's such a bullshit way to approach that, being like, debating.
Do not debate him. That is how we, you know.
It's fucking bullshit.
Yeah, it's a good move for the left to be like, debates don't count because.
Yeah, that's crazy.
We got some important debates coming up, and
but we just watched fucking Chernobyl.
Their guy can't talk.
We just watched Chernobyl, dude.
We
and
just
all of a sudden
Chernobyl.
They're saying they're going to act like the word doesn't have it. It's like the people express ideas freely. Like, yeah, right, dude.
No and chance.
Why wouldn't they want some dude, an environmentalist, to go and debate a guy who's I would say probably cozied up to Big Pharma pretty like? Why wouldn't they want that? Just for the fun of it.
I don't know.
How much aren't they offering? Like $1 million?
No,
it's gone up.
100,000.
That was Rogies. But then other people jumped in and were like, we'll donate too.
Yeah, but dude, he was like, yeah, talk to me when you have 50 million for me. It's like, brother.
Jesus Christ.
Brother. 50 mil. He was like, you could easily get that between the three of you. It's like, yeah, but they don't think the thing you're doing is good. Why would they give you $50 million to do it more? That got me fired up. I saw that whole exchange. I said,
Yeah, that was
Saturday night. He was tweeting. He was really tweeting.
Yeah.
He was getting after it.
They're like, this poor man, they're attacking him and his right-wing mudslinger sewer creature. It's like, shut up, you dorks.
Yeah, Mark Cuban got involved. I'd like to give him
what
a wedgie.
What did Cuban say?
I don't know. Bullshit. He immediately tried to sell his pharmaceutical venture.
What's his?
I don't know what it is. Yeah, he's got some type of thing where he was like
Life Plus.
Also, check out my shit. Yeah.
Didn't he tweet out during the NBA finals? Or what was the game that he tweeted out and he was like, who's illegally watching this? Mark Cuban?
That's kind of billion. That's billionaire status, yeah, though. Just be watching a game and having billions of dollars and being like, everyone should pay their $7.99
to see the Mavericks.
It was during the, I think it was the Celtics Heat game 7. And he was trying to get people to, like, he wanted to know how many people were illegally streaming.
I like how billionaires are bad boys. They're like, I'll talk about it.
Yeah.
I'll talk about illegal streaming.
I also like how Mark Cuban brought in Kyrie Irving.
Did he?
Yeah.
Beast.
Mr. fucking left wing was like, I don't care if he denies the Holocaust. This guy on my team. We got to win.
He didn't deny the Holocaust. He just retweeted a documentary.
He did the right thing. Of course.
That's such like a silent, like, that's such a funny move. I'm going to retweet that and then just log off.
It was interesting, dude.
Obviously, I'm team to Kyrie.
For sure.
Obviously.
No, I know. It's just so funny, though. Yeah. It is so funny to be like, dude, he just retweeted a documentary. I hear people say it all. He retweeted a documentary.
Yeah.
He didn't make the documentary. He just retweeted it. He just promoted it heavily.
Yeah, dude. Just because he doesn't mean he agrees with everything. Just that the Jews have been lying about being Jews.
Who the real black people are.
Exactly.
Or who the real Jews are.
I'm sure he fucking, you know, hates the Holocaust, but...
Yeah,
I can speak for Kyrie and say I think he hates Holocaust.
He's probably upset about it.
Yeah.
Well, not actively upset, but I'm sure if you bring it up, he would go, that wasn't good.
Yeah, that was terrible.
Yeah.
He could have a little bit of guilt being like, they got the wrong guys.
Oh, true. A little survivor guilt. It's like, those guys didn't even deserve it.
Those guys were so ill-informed. They're so ill-informed, dude. Yeah, the Nazis fell, you know, victim to fucking
that. That is a strike against... the black people are the real Jews argument is the guys who were like really interested in finding out who Jews were.
Yeah.
Targeted white Jews.
True.
You know what I mean?
You think they would have done the research?
Like Hitler would have done a lot of research.
And that was part of a good part of like the Nazi campaign of information was like those types of documentaries basically. You know what I mean?
What's that?
They were turning over like wild.
Oh yeah.
You know what I mean?
They're going through historical. They were like, we're the true Aryans. Like
myth, history. Yeah. They were getting into all of it. So yeah, you would have thought imagine if Hitler found out halfway through and was like, Don't no one can ever know.
Guys, I fucked up.
That'd be nuts.
That'd be awesome.
They gotta reset.
Yeah. We were just kidding. Start over. Where the fuck are we going to find black people? 3 million in? We went to Poland. Fuck. Should have went south.
That would be a sick summer blockbuster. Of just a black Jew free.
That'd be nice. Just
that'd be awesome.
Django and Glorious Bastards.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it also holds a whole thing where it's like, he's like, we're the true Jews. Hitler, you idiot. Hitler's like, get him. Tries to chase him. All the fences of the camps, they didn't know they built them like 6 feet. He's talking, what? <It's clear. laughs> What?
Just sprints through like those fucking barracks walls. He's just unstoppable.
What is this? Get him. I was listening to the Thomas Jefferson. No, it's not Thomas Jefferson. Alexander Hamilton book. He's got a weird... Did you ever get into that guy's story?
I know about Hamilton, yeah.
Yeah, dude, he's got a weird...
Little orphan boy.
He was a bastard.
Yeah.
He was a bastard. He wasn't an orphan.
Send him up. He was Caribbean, right?
Yeah, he was. But the problem was his mom was lippy, dude. She was married to this guy who came in. They think the original guy actually was a Jewish guy who was hiding the fact that he was Jewish. But he married Alexander Hamilton's mom. The mom wasn't listening to him. I think she might have had some extra, you know, marital affairs. And he just sent her to jail. He was like, yo, this lady sucks. And he locked her. He like got her into like a plantation colony prison for 4 months. And then she came out and he was like, now she knows what's up. And she just left immediately. Abandoned his whole family. Yeah, so she met another guy. And that's how Alexander was born. He did something with the court. The original husband was like, yo, she left. None of her marriages will ever be valid. So then she had a kid with Alexander Hamilton's dad, and then that way that's why he's a bastard. Because they're like, no, that lady can never have a marriage. She was like a, she went to jail for being a slut.
Nice.
Damn.
She went to slut jail, dude.
They could lock people up for that?
Yeah, dude. She did 3 months. Hard time. Dude.
3 months?
In like a fucking, like, it was
Caribbean,
like,
plantation. Yeah. That's hell.
Damn. They would, I think they dug a hole in the ground. You just sat in like a little thing, like a little like
you
hobbit
just thought
house.
About your actions?
But yeah, you just chilled.
Was, were they trying to like reform sluts back then?
I think so. Bad wives, specifically.
Damn.
If you're a bad wife.
Sluts still go there, though.
Oh, you know big what I mean? Time.
To the hole in the ground?
No, they go to the Caribbean. There's something in there. It's like when turtles go to the same island. Sluts just have to get down there. Steel drums.
They're called. They feel a force bringing them to the Caribbean.
No, Hamilton's a man.
Yeah, I want to get. I wish I got further into that. I could have brought more to the conversation about Hamilton, but I just know.
Sorry,
about
he links with Washington, and then Washington loves him.
Yeah.
That was in that Marquis de Lafayette book. Mm. They were his two bros.
The homies, yeah. Yeah, yeah, it's a shame, though. He was just fucking tortured by his bastardous past.
Yeah, read the book and then watch Hamilton.
I'm reading the book Hamilton was based on right now.
Yeah.
I tried to watch Hamilton. It was so bad.
It stinks.
Yeah, it was just like, dude, give me the story straight, man.
Yeah.
What the hell? What's all this crap, dude? This
is bullshit.
You don't like the songs?
No.
No, the songs piss me off.
Really?
Almost more than any other songs.
I love musical songs.
I turned it on.
I
was like, it's Christmas time in the West Indies. Yeah. It's like, what the fuck is this?
Dude, there's some good-ass musical songs.
I mean, dude,
Hamilton's
don't get me started
not
on
it.
There are good musical songs.
Yeah.
Tradition. I mean, Fiddler on the Roof had some bangers.
Yeah.
Phaantom of the Opera?
I don't know any of those.
Oh.
What's the big one?
Once
in
I hear
sleep,
that.
He came to me.
You don't know that? It's awesome. It's a banger.
The Phaaantom of the Opera is here.
I know that one. That was
inside massive. Your mind.
That's pretty sick. Dude.
Wicked.
If you think about
it, just say it was the Phaaantom of the Opera with a fucked up face. You just sent it to me. I was texting you. Fuck.
Oh, who'd you say was
you
doing?
Sent it. You sent it a gif of the Phaantom of the Opera. Oh, it was me with the cold sore.
You're not your cold sore.
I got a cold sore in my mouth. I was like, fuck, I have to do a show.
Yeah, I said you should Phaantom of the Opera if you're half a man.
That would be so funny. If you filmed your special with a fucking Phaantom of the Opera mask on.
Thank God. The cold sore is almost done. Would have been a soul-crushing defeat, dude.
Oh, that would have been awesome.
For the special to
CGI
have a fucking disgusting herpes on my mouth.
That dude, you were bemoaning it. That couldn't have come at a better time.
Perfect time.
It was crazy.
Yeah.
Like, now you're definitely not going to think about one.
Now the stress of this induced a nice herpes on my mouth.
Yeah.
Are you stressing?
I am stressing. Last night didn't help. I was watching, this is a funny story, I was watching Fox News over my dinner. And they cut to a preview for Rob Schneider's new special. And then it's just one of his jokes is just exactly the same as mine. And I'm sitting there eating dinner. And I was like, oh, fuck.
It's also such a unique way for someone to spin out is watching Fox News and seeing a comedian with the same being like, what the
fuck?
What
are the odds? I haven't watched Fox News in months. I was like, fuck it, I'll just put on some TV.
Yeah.
While I'm eating dinner, and then it just cuts to a guy doing my material. I was like, wait.
That's
how do we have this? I'm doing it anyway. And then all day I've been walking around in my head just like, I'm fucking doing it. Who cares? Obviously, I didn't see it. I've been doing this material for fucking 2 years.
That's
I never saw that.
That's torture.
Well, yeah. What a wild way to find out.
Yeah. Fox News running ads for stand-up. And it's just the one joke they used in the trailer.
Yeah.
Just funny eating it.
It's for real. That's exactly what I did. I was like, I just heard it slightly. And then I heard it.
Yeah.
He's like, Joe Biden's like if Joe Biden were a dog, you'd put him down. And I was like, fuck.
That sucks.
It's kind of like an integral part of that whole fucking.
No, that's a byline,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, it is. I'm keeping it, dude.
Yeah, for sure.
Mine's different, but it's still,
It's a byline, bro. I thought you were talking about a whole, like...
No, I'm sure, though.
Chunk.
That happens.
It's gotta.
It's always a bummer. Nothing worse.
I had to drop something.
Nothing worse is when someone tells you about it, too.
Someone messaged me.
It's like, just don't even tell me.
Yeah. Someone messaged me, said I was cutting real close to Tom Segura with a thing about once you have kids, you don't care about your dogs anymore.
He's got a bit about that.
Yeah, but that's also...
Yeah. And it wasn't nothing... It wasn't integral.
There's premises that are very common.
True.
That happens.
Yeah. But no, it's a worse feeling. You're like, what else of mine's already been fucking done?
Oh, yeah. Everything I'm saying has been done.
You think that.
You do. And then you see it, and you're like, or like, you see where you, like,
mm-hmm.
you're like, oh, fuck, is that where I got that? like oh, something like that where you're like, oh no.
You start thinking maybe you osmosed a thing. Yeah. Like maybe you osmosed an idea. And yeah.
I got my osmosed from Rob Schneider. I was like,
yeah. Schneider's the man.
He is the man.
If he saw you right now, he stood up. He clasped hands. Yeah, he'd see you right now.
He was
hands.
Like very vocal during the SNL yeah, thing.
Dude. Was he really?
Schneider was yeah, all man. Over it.
He'd fucking
was he
great.
On SNL?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He'd for great minds. Time. He'd go great minds, yeah. bro. Great fucking minds.
Schneider's the bro.
Yeah, dude. There were some of those bros. Brewer's the bro.
Brewer's the ultimate bro.
Absolute bro. I had a when I rode back with this Uber driver, the way up, I told it last week I was saying it was a guy from like Afghanistan beast. Came back with this just dude from like, you know, Northeast Philly somewhere. And he, I just assumed we were on the same wavelength. So we're talking about stuff, start talking about the vax. And I'm going like, oh, dude, he's putting the bat signal out. I'm going to drop it on him. Like, yeah, dude, fuck that. And he was like, actually, I needed it. My father would have died without it. I was like, oh, shit, my bad, dude. I was like, my bad. And then we started talking. Then we started talking comedy. I'm like, but he was being nice. Then we started talking about comedy and he was like, yeah, I saw Jim Brewer. I'm like, yeah, he's the man. He was like, yeah, he's just fucking right wing now. And I'm like, God damn it, dude. Wow. I can't talk to this guy about fucking anything.
Yeah.
Well, he was like, you can't really tell, but I think he's kind of right wing. And it was just kind of like, he's like, yeah, well, talking about Trump. And he was like, yeah, well, Trump gave everyone permission to be racist. And I was like, I quit. I fucking quit trying to be your
white
boy.
Uber driver?
Yeah. I quit trying to be your boy.
White Uber drivers are the worst thing imaginable. like when you go on the road, I always get white Uber drivers on the road.
Every, outside of New York, cities, there's white Uber drivers.
Yeah,
and they don't stop talking.
They do
I
not.
Like the chat. I like the chat. The chat.
I don't like the chat. I don't like the chat of telling you all about the town.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was it? Yeah. Remember when we got to South Carolina, that guy just gave us the tour.
Yep.
It was kind of nice.
We did. I did.
He hit us with some good stuff.
I had the one guy the one time who just went, yo, they have beer there. Beer's that beer.
Oh, the Mexican
good.
Guy.
Yeah, Mexican guy.
The beer there is
they
so
have
good.
Beer there. That's a beer. They have some good beers there.
I got hit with that guy, though. That same type of guy. I was doing hyenas during the pandemic. And it was the first one I did that was like packed in Texas. And I was like, yeah, fuck. I was at the bar. I figured this bartender from fucking Fort Worth, Texas was going to be pretty cool about the vax being gay.
Yeah.
And I was like, dude, the vax fucking bullshit. I was like, COVID's fucking bullshit anyway. He's like, I was on a ventilator for 3 months in the hospital. I was
Jesus like, Christ.
My bad, dude.
Was it like a man bunned up like bartender or was it like just a regular dude?
I remember bald head, fucking like looked like a Texas man. But I mean, I guess he got hit with that ventilator and was like, no, this shit's real, dude.
Yeah,
I don't care how conservative I was.
True.
It's like I was in the hospital for 3 months with COVID.
That is the wormhole of the Democratic Party. No disrespect.
Yeah.
You hit the Darth Vader breath for a couple of months, dude. You come out and you're like, mine is my guy.
You sit up like Vader at the end of that one. Like, no!
That's so scary. That was my greatest nightmare of getting onto the vent, dude. When I had it, I was like, dude, I'm going to hit
it sucked.
Because you lay there and you go, yeah, my breathing's all right. I guess it could be better. And you go, oh, fuck, I'm going on the vent.
You don't breathe again. You lay
get it together, dude. It's just your mind getting you excited. It's a little harder now. I wonder what that's about. Oh, it's even harder now that I think about it. Oh, God.
Damn, you had it bad?
I got whacked for like 2 days.
And yeah, that's what it was for me.
All of the customers got whacked. They all hit it from each other.
Talked about it.
They're all like, nah, I'm good.
We all got it.
All got crushed,
and I called Billy. I'm like, where are you at? He's like, I just woke up. I'm like, the fuck are you doing sleeping, dude? It's a work day. Yeah, I think I have like an itch in my throat. Everyone hit it from each
They're
other.
They're all devastated.
That's so funny. That's hilarious.
Are they like you, though? Are they like slightly hypochondriacs?
Probably,
where they're all like, oh no, it's hard to breathe.
I guarantee Billy for sure is.
Yeah.
All my brothers probably are.
Have you only had it once?
Yeah, Billy had it once. I didn't think twice. I had allegedly twice, but.
I had it three times.
Three times?
Yeah.
Damn.
I get sick pretty easily. I don't really have a strong immune system.
Immunocompromised?
I don't know. Something.
Damn.
Were you homeschooled?
Yeah. No.
All right.
Why?
Nothing.
That's serious. Like the meanest thing you could possibly
no, it's
say.
Not. Yeah. No, it's not.
Just asking the question. Even just asking the question is mean. You seem like you didn't. You weren't around people growing up.
You don't. Yeah, you were in complete command of the green room, dude. He came to my show on Sunday. It was just
total
in the pocket, dude.
Really?
Yeah.
Awesome. I don't think I was.
He was holding court in the green room, and it was
I was
very
just talking.
Fun.
No one talks.
No, you were so
No one
funny.
Talks. Everyone just sits there.
Yeah, it's
and waits
weird.
For someone to talk.
Yeah.
So I was like, I'll talk.
He's becoming a man before our eyes, dude. I thought about that. Yeah. You're becoming a man. How old are you now?
22.
Jesus Christ.
God damn.
Yeah.
You have to get married
young
soon.
Boy. Dude. You just got out of homeschool, dude.
Did you ever see Bad Boy Bubby?
No.
Oh, you got to watch Bad Boy Bubby.
What's that?
It's about an Australian movie about a guy whose parents convince him that the outside air is poisonous. So they keep him inside his whole life and he can't go out. He just has sex. He has sex with his mom.
Oh.
Yeah. And eventually he it's fucked up. He can only have sex
That's
with his
where
mom.
I expected that to go.
There's the other one, Bubble Boy, with Jake Gyllenhaal.
It'd be funny to get them too confused.
Like, he's fucked his mom. I was like, I don't know if I remember that part.
But no, yeah, then he eventually gets out and just is like, goes on a tear.
He's a bad boy.
It's a sick movie. Bad Boy Bubby is a sick movie.
Nice.
I just Sounds wanted to good. Talk about it. You don't give Bad Boy Bubby vibes at all. You don't at all. He's
I'm
a menace.
Good. I'm
bad
glad.
Boy Bubby is a fucking menace.
You're a good boy.
I try my best.
You are a good boy.
You are good. You actually are a really good boy. For real. No, seriously.
Yeah, Sass is a little good guy. A
lot of your generation's lost, dude.
Your generation's
They're
a bunch
on their
of
phones too much.
Fucking punks on their phones.
I think everyone's on their phones.
I'm not on my phone.
Dude, I'm getting off.
You're not?
Right now.
Yeah.
Dude, I've been able to identify.
You see my screen time? It's like 14 hours.
Yeah. No, are you really?
Is
no,
it actually
no,
that
it's
high?
It's not 14. No.
What you clocking in at?
I don't know. Probably something crazy.
Mine's like 8 or 9.
Especially a hangover day yesterday.
Yeah. Traveling, when you're in the hotel.
Today I'm at 1 hour and 51 minutes.
That's not bad.
Considering I've been awake since 11, that's pretty bad.
Usually give you the average. Not bad. I'm down to 230. Well, it just went up 239 daily average. But when I hit the hotels
Damn,
traveling.
239 average is
Mine's
great.
Not bad. Mine's 4.5, 4 or 5.
That's where I was hovering around there for a while.
But for a while, mine was like 9.
Dude. We checked one time. Sid the Kid was rocking a 15-hour DA, daily 15? Average.
15?
He said he keeps it playing ambient in the background.
Yeah, I was going to say, how enough. Does that even happen?
Oh, it's, nice. My daily average is 3.5.
That's not bad, dude.
3.5 is not it. Bad at all.
No, nah, dude. It. That's not bad. I think the average person's
Although it might
around,
be including today, that hour 50.
It's still can, you know, I can't freak the average. Yeah. I just requested that my wife put her screen time monitor on. Yeah, so it's good data to have. She's like, I don't want to. I was like, just put it on.
Oh, for her to look at.
Yeah. Oh. So just check it out.
I thought you meant for you to monitor. I was like, man.
I'm going to ask her about it.
It's a little wacky.
I keep it down, you know. If I see her on it too much, I go, come on.
Yeah.
Put the fucking phone down.
What do you want? What do you want a lot?
The apps.
Instagram and
apps?
Twitter.
Yeah.
I just, yeah.
The apps?
I just look at the apps. I try to find, I'll get in a Wikipedia hole occasionally.
I'm on
really?
Shazam.
Last night,
Shazam all day.
Shazam. What
the
is
this?
Just 7 hours on Uber Eats.
Singing songs, trying to think
I'm
of
in
them.
I'm in a coffee shop.
Oh, Arcade Fire. I haven't thought of them in
you
forever.
You never rewrite it down. You're like, cool. Put your phone away.
I got a nice Wikipedia one last night.
Oh, what'd you get?
I got Battle of Agincourt.
Mm.
Pretty big. I was watching the movie The King on Netflix. You saw that one with Timothy Chalamet.
Oh, yeah.
It's a great
yeah.
movie.
That was tight.
It's awesome. Anyway.
If you're tired of always having to stand outside in the rain and snow to get your nicotine fix, it's time to try something new. Lucy lets you get your nicotine wherever and whenever you want it.
Let's go. Airplanes. Airplanes are the best.
Oh, for fucking sure. Whether you're a gum man or enjoy a badass nicotine pouch, Lucy has the best nicotine products in the game. Choose your strength and your flavor with options like apple ice, mango, and espresso. There's no wrong pick.
My favorite's mango.
Oh, yeah. I like apple ice.
Do you like apple ice?
I give it to my dogs.
I feed my dogs nicotine pouches. They're not doing well. I say, watch it.
If you love nicotine pouches, you're in for a treat. Lucy Breaker pouches have liquid flavor capsules inside that burst to moisten the pouch and give you a wave of awesome flavor.
Mm.
Visit lucy.co and use promo code DRENCHED to get 20% off your first order. Shipping is always free. That's lucy.co, promo code DRENCHED to receive 20% off and always free shipping. Here comes a fine print. Lucy products are only for adults of legal age, and every order is age verified. This product contains nicotine. Nicotine is an addictive chemical.
Boy, is it ever. All right. Guys, smoking should be fun. If you're having coughing fits every time you take a sweet hit, it's time to get Freeze Pipe. Freeze Pipe gives you the coldest and smoothest hits that are easy on the lungs. Just pop the pipe's glycerin chamber into the freezer for an hour. As smoke passes through the chamber, it's cooled by over 300 degrees. Personal endorsement, talk it up.
Dude, how blazed did you get the other day?
When I pop that fucking chamber in and get high.
Dude.
I love getting high.
You do handstand bong rips, so it goes right to your head.
I sit here by myself, and I do handstand bong rips.
And you smoke a cig right
ice
after.
Ice cold chamber. My fucking, never mind. Whether you're into pipes, bongs, or bubblers, Freeze Pipe has you covered with the most comfortable way to smoke. Guys, there's over 1,100 reviews and a 4.4 star rating. Get ready to be popular at every party when you bring your Freeze Pipe. Bring a Freeze Pipe to a fucking party. House party, dude. To a kid's fucking birthday party. Say, guys, don't worry. The bong riffs we've been taking are too harsh. I've got a solution. So, for a premium smoking experience at everyday great prices and free shipping, visit thefreezepipe.com and use code DRENCHED for 10% off your entire order. That's freezepipe.com and use code DRENCHED for 10% off. freezepipe.com/drenched. Come on.
It's almost the 4th of July and the real American dream is having smooth balls. Celebrate freedom by picking up Manscaped's Performance Package 4.0 with everything you need to get grooming. It includes a lawnmower 4.0 with cutting-edge ceramic blade and an LED spotlight so you can shave in the dark of night. The kit also comes with Manscaped's Crop Preserver, Ball Deodorant, and Crop Reviver Ball Toner.
You know what I've noticed about all that shaving cream stuff?
What?
Girls like to use it to shave their pussy. It feels good there, too.
I can see that, yeah.
So, if you have a girl living with you, she'll shave her pussy with your Manscaped stuff.
Little woman Manscaped.
And it looks nice when it's shaved.
True. Glistens.
I go, whoa, what are you, 12?
It's a fair question. What, did you hit a time machine and now you're 12?
You hit a time machine and your pussy went back in time?
You have to tell me. I don't want any trouble, ma'am. The kit also comes with Manscaped's Crop Preserver Ball Deodorant. If that's not enough, they're also throwing in an anti-chafing boxers and travel bag.
That's something we need for the summer.
I think I have them on right now. So you're prepared for wherever your celebration takes you. Riff on trimming pubes. There's nothing funny about it.
Nothing to riff about when it comes to shaving.
Yeah,
pubes.
I put it. It's serious business. I go into the toilet. My wife goes, "You're getting them on the floor." And I say, "You leave fucking hair in the shower." She said, "It goes down the drain." I said, "You can clog the fucking pipes that way."
Yeah.
And I said, "Just leave me be, all right?" That's my trimming pubes experience.
I'm trying to look nice for you. I love when I have a presentable penis and nuts.
I'm going to meet your parents. Want to make your face as smooth
you
as
want
your
my cock to be covered in hair when I meet your parents? My cock is hairless.
I sweat right in my khaki where my pubes are, and everybody knows.
Everybody knows I have a giant bush. Everybody's been laughing at me.
Want to make your face as smooth as your balls?
I'm about to meet your father for the first time. My cock's going to be fucking smooth, dude.
He might check it. Add on a Manscaped Beards Hedger trimmer to be the bald eagle you dream to be. Take your freedom bells to the next level by going to manscaped.com and get 20% off free shipping with our discount code DRENCHED. That's manscaped.com, code DRENCHED, for 20% off and free shipping. Get your independence back this Independence Day and unlock your confidence with Manscaped.
What the fuck are they talking about? I don't know, dude. Back to the show.
So what happened? What happened?
Battle of Agincourt?
Yeah,
just
what was
the fucking, the English killed all the frogs. Frogs outnumbered them like 3-1 and got killed.
What?
Wait, what? That was a real fight?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn.
How did they do it? What was the strategy?
It was the British. The English longbow was big, dude.
Yeah.
That was big. And then the frogs got stuck in the mud. and they were smashing against each other. And then, King Henry executed all of the prisoners. Which was pretty weird back then to do.
Just out of nowhere?
Yeah, he executed like 10,000 strong, but he executed like for real, like maybe 2,000 prisoners.
Yeah, didn't break a single bead of sweat though, dude. King Henry.
He can't sweat. It's just the royal blood. Never.
Can't get off the phones, dude.
Never interrupt the podcast ever again. I was talking about the Battle of Agincourt with my friends that I vaguely remember. I vaguely remember the details that I'm trying to.
No, that's all you need. The guy fucking, the frogs got stuck in the mud.
The frogs got stuck
in
the mud.
Longbow.
Yeah.
And then the lady blew in that one dude's ear and he fucking missed. From a Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves. Yeah. How sick. Did you ever watch the music video for that song?
Robin Hood?
Yeah, Prince of Thieves. It was fucking Brian Adams. You know what I'm talking about?
No
idea. Shazam it.
Is Shazam like a build-in on Siri?
Well, you got played, dude.
Oh, dude, it's the music video is so fucking good. I would die for you. You never heard that song?
I might
everything
have.
Everything I do.
Oh, yeah.
And everything
I don't think I've heard it.
Yo, that one?
Yo, Sass, when you're alone with a girl... Let me tell you about this. This is gonna blow your fucking mind, dude. The music video is so fucking nasty. Right now, you guys are on a couch, just ate dinner.
You go like this.
You're holding hands. You're holding
like this. You go like this.
You guys are holding both hands at your house. It's going like this.
And you're in your head, you're going, fuck, I forgot to shave my pubes. Oh, shit, I forgot how long my pubes are. Oh fuck.
Oh, I didn't wipe my ass all that well.
Oh no, I have shit in my pants. I'm gonna have to tell her. It's gonna stink down there. I hope you don't mind a little stink.
Brian Adams, dude. This is a hunk, dude.
I didn't know this was Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves.
I've never heard this song.
Yeah, dude.
Tell me it's not worth fighting for. Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, dude.
Good song.
The song's beautiful, great bro. Song. People want to listen to that and not debate, dude. Don't tell me, dude.
You got to listen to that, and then you got to go on the JRE experience and debate.
Debate. He needs to listen to that doctor. That fucking...
That dork, dude. I hate that
He needs to come down
dork,
from his
dude.
Ivory tower, dude. I was so mad at him. And all
these
people being like,
really
we need
up?
To protect this man at all costs. Did he invent the vaccine or something?
No.
Yeah, they're acting like he...
Yeah.
What the hell did the guy do?
I forget. I don't think he's ever done anything.
For real?
I think he helped patent one of the
Watch it.
Yeah. Watch it. Well, then how am I going to get to the gym? Call an Uber. Call an Uber to the grocery store. Then what? I'm just stuck here? That's crazy.
Did you see that?
What?
There was a thing. Someone's ring doorbell foot. That was actually kind of invasion.
Yeah, that's bullshit.
Oh. Wait, what was it? What was it? I think I might have seen it.
It was this guy.
this guy. No, but I will say this. They're hitting him with abusive, and it's like, no.
Yeah, that was...
Being a brat is being a brat, but it's not abusive. It's
wait, was it fucking... what's his name?
Crowder.
Yeah, it was Crowder. Yeah, I saw it. Yeah, that video was crazy.
And who knows what she did before that, dude. She might be taking the car a lot.
This was a while
ago. But they said there was a cut. They said there was a cut interlude. They had that, and then they had the cut... And they're like, oh, at this point in the cut, he said he'd beat her fucking ass. And it was like, I saw that. I went, maybe. But also, I need to see. Show me the tape.
He was really mad.
He was angry. He was furious.
He was actually sitting just like Matt is right now.
Yeah,
he was. Watch it.
Which I mean, that's like, for angry and being in that position, that's like an intimidating
dude,
thing.
I will say this. And, you know, if you're already fighting with your wife and then she becomes pregnant, there's not like an easy off switch to be like, all right, I'm not going to fight with her while she's... You can fight with a pregnant lady.
Yeah.
I've done it.
Yeah.
I fought with a pregnant lady, dude. I'm not, you know, it's not my proudest moment, but it's like, you do it. And you're like, what am I doing? So yeah, I did feel badly that got released. I was like, that is really shitty.
How did he get released? Did she release it?
She must have.
She crushed him. Although again, he could have been torturing her behind, who knows, dude. I tried to speak on
the
domestic
abuse was strong though in that, particularly in that video.
Yeah.
He was just bragging.
What were they saying? He was gaslighting her?
I mean, anytime you win an argument with a woman, that was a straw man. You gaslight me. Like,
he was
you don't even know what these words mean, idiot.
He was bludgeoning her with logic, dude.
He bludgeoned her with logic. He sat down with the coffee and said, prove to me that I'm not right. Change my mind about taking an Uber right now.
You should pick up the dog poop. Change my mind.
He's just always got the sign on him. Just in a bag.
That'd be nice though to be
in the middle of an argument. Just like, 1 second.
You can take an Uber, change my mind.
Dude, if I could go into like girl mind and just like, if I'm his wife, I would just be sitting there and being like, I mean, I don't know. I think like drag story time's not that big of an idea.
Oh, you could.
Watch it.
Watch it. Watch it. You're the mother of my child. Watch it.
Throwing out a watch it to anyone is just insane.
Watch it's unbelievable.
That's insane.
Watch it's unbelievable.
It's
unbelievable.
So nice.
Someone your age, too.
Fucking watch it.
Hey.
Cool it. Cool it. Change your tone.
You're on thin ice.
You're on fucking thin ice.
You gotta turn off the dinner time Fox News, dude.
Yeah.
You might mentally time travel, dude.
I was watching Fox News and I was like, yeah. I was eating dinner. I was locked in. I am
until they get you.
Between specials, I did turn into a Fox News dad. 100%.
You're gonna start taking up the being like, watch it, pal. Hey, buddy.
Yeah, I'm trying to.
You creep. It's my dad's top shit.
Creep.
You creep.
Guy's being a creep.
Dude, he would get up if we were out eating when we were little, and like there was like teenage boys cursing. We had a pizza place in like the Poconos, and he'd go over the table and be like, would you creep stop cursing? Knock it off. I have kids here. And they'd be like, watch your mouths. Dude, it was so funny.
That's nice.
He lived for
that's a badass move.
Punks.
Kids scared the fuck out of me. Snot nose
punks.
Dude, snot nose punks.
Kids do?
Yeah.
It's because you're homeschooled. Like, what are those? I've never even seen one of those.
I just don't want to get bullied by a group of kids.
Yeah, of course.
I cross the street when I see them coming my way.
Really? What type of kids do you cross the street for?
Yeah, all of them.
School zone. Just in a school zone.
I live kind of in a school zone, and they're always running around outside my house. One of them was filming a TikTok outside of my apartment.
Awesome.
And I was playing video games with my friends. I stood up to take a picture of them, and they saw me take the picture.
With a headset on?
With my headset on and pajama pants. And they stood outside of my apartment waving at me until I went out and said something.
We had to go out and address them.
You had to address the mob.
I had to address them. And they were like, did you just take a video of us? And I was like, no. The fuck are you guys talking about?
Ooh.
And then,
real problem.
They were like teens. They weren't children. And
still a problem.
And they asked if I could buy them Taylor Swift tickets.
Yeah, I've heard that argument.
Are you old enough to like date a 16-year-old by common law, right? 22. Can't you take like a 16-year-old to prom or something your age?
I think schools it caps out at like 18.
Oh, really?
Or depending on the school. I don't think high schools want like 22-year-olds.
I thought you could marry like a 22-year-old.
Rolling up to
prom. Marry like a 16-year-old.
Probably.
There's windows. If you were to
there was 22
if you were to hold
year
hands
prom?
Like a 17-year-old and listen to Brian Adams, I think you'd be okay.
Yeah.
I don't do it, obviously. Don't do it. Yeah. Check your
Maybe.
Local law, but
yeah. Check your local listings. You might be able to do that, dude.
Oh, that would be horrifying.
Why? That'd be awesome.
17-year-olds?
They're so funny.
You're not.
Their pussies are so funny.
I just want to talk to them. Jesus, Harry.
What the hell, dude?
Their tight young
Harry.
Pussies are hilarious.
I mean, you're probably legally allowed to say that at your age.
You are. I was watching Marie Antoinette. Have you ever seen that movie?
No.
It's pretty.
I know of her.
It was making me laugh at the beginning. Austria gives Marie Antoinette to France as like they're like, we need to become allies and like solidify this. It's just funny to see them being like, here's a sweet little piece of pussy for you.
Yeah, Drew.
Deal. We're friends now. Here's a 14-year-old's pussy. We're going to send it over there.
Well, the whole country was pumped. They hated her, right?
Towards the end, yeah.
Towards the end, yeah.
They cut her fucking head off.
But yeah, I know they did that. But at first, weren't they kind of like, because you would send like one country a young babe and they'd all be like, yo, for real, like we should get along. They would worship one babe and be like,
I think they liked Marie Antoinette at first, at least according to the movie.
She was cultured, wasn't she? She like came down and was like, this is how you use a spoon.
I'm not sure.
Farmers were like,
the movie
fuck.
Was, I doubt, extremely accurate historically.
Yeah. God, that must suck, dude. They cut her head off.
Yeah. Ooh, it was making me laugh thinking about that fucking Louis bit, the fucking first world problems bit.
Which one?
Where he's just like explaining. He invented like the first world problems, I think.
Did he coin the term?
Yeah, he did it in a special.
That's pretty sick.
He was like, first world problems are like, whatever, like this line's taking too long or something. He's like, third world problems are like, you wake up one day and you're like, oh, fuck, I forgot they're going to cut all our heads off. Oh, they're cutting all our heads off today. Fuck. The whole time I was watching it, I was like, God, I can't wait till they cut all these people's heads off.
Yeah.
Just gay Frenchmen running around in their fucking dumb outfits. Like, woo, love making the passion. I'm like, there's just hungry dudes outside that are dirty. They're like, we're getting in there. I'm going to cut those fucking fruitcakes' heads off, dude. I'm starving. They just partied for like 20 years and then they all got their heads cut off.
What was the name of the place they were all hanging
Versailles.
Out? Versailles. Yeah. Just being absolutely fruity.
Literally the nicest place of all time.
Oh.
And they were in there, having drinks, fucking each other. Everybody was fucking everybody.
Yeah, everyone had a mistress and shit back then.
Marquis de Lafayette. He was like ousted from the court because he wouldn't cheat. Yeah. Everyone was like, dude, you're being a bitch. We don't need you around our crew. Dude, we're all getting pussy on the side.
Yeah.
Don't think you're better than us. And then they all got their heads cut off.
Did he get his head cut off?
No. But he got a lot. He had a lot of problems. He was in jail a lot.
It's better than having your head get cut off.
Yeah.
Especially they probably had dull ass blades back then.
Just, oh.
Yeah, fuck, it didn't take.
It's like a paper cutter.
Yeah.
Head cut off is pretty funny.
Yeah. Have you ever seen any of those videos?
Yes.
The live leakies?
Yeah.
I've virgin eyes when it comes to that stuff.
It's not good. It's not good.
Especially the beheadings on there are never, it's never a guillotine.
It's never a clean cut.
It's always a knife and a fucking.
Yeah.
You see the guy going like, ah!
Yeah. Jesus.
Does anyone get a clean cut?
Jesus, mister.
Does anyone get a clean cut?
Yeah, I think the Afghanis and Saudis got it down pretty good.
That's not bad.
They were hitting, I think the Taliban used to hit like soccer stadium beheadings. And they were once.
Oh, yeah, and the whole
slice,
town comes out
town
for
would
it.
Be like, dude.
Oh, really?
What are you doing after
Afghanistan
work today?
Rocks.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's something we miss about that, like public justice, like brutal public justice. I think there's something that if
we seek it online, dude.
True.
That's why I was just mad at that science dork.
True, yeah.
That was my public beheading.
I just want to see him
crucify.
I
want
to see
Joe.
One person debate someone who knows anything. I've never seen anyone do it yet.
What if he just pantses RFK Jr.?
Fair
dude?
Enough.
That'd be so fun.
I'd be so sad. But, dude, I don't think he will because they had something close to it. Rogies almost kind of debated himself a little bit. Who was the guy who went on Rogies and tried to, like, oh, fucking that weirdo Sanjay Gupta.
Yeah.
Sanjay Gupta would try to go on
and
there.
Rogies stomped him.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying, man. And
it was
like
a bloodbath.
It was a total fucking
bloodbath.
And they're
like, oh, this guy, what's he going to eat? Fucking elk meat and talk about wrestling.
That's
it's like,
I'm
well,
saying.
Then beat him in a debate. You're the CNN guy.
You're a medical doctor.
Yeah.
Rogie stomped him in that debate.
It was a bloodbath.
That's
dude.
Probably why they're like,
can't go in there.
Well, because they get into the funding and the funding.
They also,
really
they don't understand
freaky.
Rogies has been investigating this for 3 years now.
True.
Like nonstop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, he got fucking crucified.
I love watching the videos of Rogan getting mad at people.
Yeah, it's
of his
nice.
Guests. Have you ever seen the one of him, of the dude asking if he could like do the podcast, like take over the podcast for a week? You've never seen that?
No.
If Rogan was like, what the fuck are you talking about? he's like, what do you have to offer me that would be equal to me giving you this platform for a full week? And the guy's like, I just think it would be like a really good idea.
I think it would be good for me.
Yeah.
Who was it? Probably, do you remember?
I don't know, but that guy definitely was in the shower being like, he might be into the ideas like that.
Yeah. He's a pretty open-minded guy.
And then everyone would see that I'm actually great.
I'm going to try it. Shit. Just fucking kill me.
Dude.
Just fucking kill me right now.
Nightmare.
Yeah, I bombed on there and that was bad, dude. That was cutting our fucking heads off.
Yeah.
I wish someone would have cut my head off right then, dude.
And that was early in the episode.
I wish Jamie
would have
fucking
30 minutes in.
Oh, red face, just like, what?
Yeah.
It is great. Doesn't he still not get the joke?
He gets it.
He gets it now?
Yeah. He understood it then. He thought, I mean, there is a part of the joke where there's something underlying it. If it was about you, you'd be like, you're accusing me of not helping you. That's the part he took from it.
Yeah, it makes sense.
But the joke was I was arrogant and stupid. And I was like, I'll just go on Rogan. I don't give a fuck. He's definitely going to have me on.
He's like, wait, what?
And then he's like, who are you?
Fuck. Shit, 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 shit. Well, you know, because you figure like you'd be in with something like this situation.
I just figured you might have heard of it.
How long after did you go on?
It's like 2 years.
Oh, okay.
Oh, year, so you had, it was 2 years after.
Yeah.
Time is flying, dude.
Yeah, time's flying.
What the hell?
That was 4 years ago this September.
Hey. Damn, 4 years ago?
I think four.
Hey. That's crazy.
3 or 4.
Oh, you're right. It's 2023, dude.
Yeah, it was 2019.
That's wild.
September 12th, 2019.
I was in high school.
I remember the date because it was 9/11 when I got the news that I was going to be on.
That's pretty, that's significant.
A great 9/11.
Yeah, it was a good 9/11. It was another good 9/11.
Yeah. True.
Add it to the board. So far, I've had nothing but good 9/11s.
The only one, you know, the one first bad one was spoiled a bunch.
Nuts.
Yeah.
Recess all day.
True.
Had no clue what was going on.
I got to watch TV in the daytime.
Get to watch TV in class. Teachers are crying. You're like, this is crazy.
And your enemies.
Teachers are sobbing.
Your enemies, like, what are they? Fell, dude.
We had to go to the church.
Teachers cried.
Church?
We went to church.
They sent us right home.
We went to church, and then certain kids started getting picked up. And I was like, damn, I wish my parents would fucking pick me up. Of course they didn't.
Yeah.
I just spent the full day at recess.
Did you guys get, like, did you guys have school the next day?
I don't remember.
I think
I do not recall.
I think
I'm pretty sure we just
day.
Yeah.
No one... I think it was business as usual.
And then that was when everybody started talking. They're like, they're gonna get us.
They're going for fucking.
McCarricksburg has such a huge Navy depot. They're like, dude, they're targeting the Navy depot.
New York City was first. Mechanicsburg is next.
They want Mechanicsburg. They did get fucking Somerset.
Oh yeah.
Who knows? They were trying to hit those wind turbines.
In the Fertile Crescent.
Trying to up the price of oil.
It took me years to understand the significance of that. I was kind of like, what's the big deal?
Yeah.
New York. I was like, okay. It's like a bunch of people died. I'm like, seems like a decent amount. But
yeah.
It's crazy that they thought it was like 20,000 people.
Yeah.
Originally.
I mean, they did the math on how many people work there every day. And it's like an insane amount.
Yeah. Who would have thought we had 18,000 quiet quitters? Where the hell were you guys?
Dude, I was watching. So there's this 9/11. There's a 9/11 documentary. It's like the best one. It was on the History Channel, and it was just footage. It was just chronological, and it was home videos.
Yeah.
And one of them's these students from NYU.
I've seen that video.
And they're like, but I never.
And they're
saw,
all drinking
they
beer.
They never showed in the documentary. They never showed them drinking.
Yeah.
And then
it's
like this week a video came out. They're all like, while the towers are on fire, the first plane's already, actually the second plane hit because they collapsed. These kids are just drinking beer, like watching it. And then the one girl just was like, oh my God.
It's a wild video.
What do we do?
It's a wild video.
Also, if it's the same video,
it was
I'm
like
thinking,
10 a.m. too.
It's really early, and they're
drinking
out of like pint glasses.
Oh. Classes are canceled. Let's get a couple brewskis, watch the fire.
Oh my God.
But they also, if it's the same video, I'm thinking there were people jumping.
Oh, I didn't see that in the video.
They claimed there was no jumpers.
Who? Pictures
of
jumpers?
Oh, I'm thinking of the Great Depression. My bad.
I was like, there's a lot of jumpers.
Yeah, yeah, there was no jumpers, the Great Depression.
On the stock market crash?
Yeah, they're like, nobody actually jumped. I'm thinking of two different things.
Yeah, there's that famous photo of the dude like head first going down.
I don't think he's ever been identified.
Probably not. I mean, jumped from fucking
falling man.
High up.
Yeah, true.
It's a scary vid, dude.
Yeah.
No, I mean, you think somebody from the picture would be like, of the dead people will be like that.
Oh, yeah.
That looks
dude.
Like my husband.
So what's the thought behind that? It's burned to death or splat?
Yeah. I think it was like you couldn't breathe and what you were holding on to was so hot. You had to just let go or jump. Yeah. I'll take the jump over the burn to death. Burn to death blows, dude.
I don't know if I could get myself to jump.
You would at least try your sneakers to grip on the side.
See if you can. Bam, 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 bam.
Yeah.
Bam, 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 bam. Just like one time. Fuck.
Fire department's watching. He goes, going. Squeaky. All the way
he's going
to
make it.
Holy shit.
He's going to do it. He's like, oh, nope. He's off. He's off.
Spit on your hands and wipe your shoes.
It's like a basketball court. No, that, the jumpers was truly the most haunting part of that entire.
It's terrible.
The jumpers was the scariest part by far.
Yeah, I saw a video on Twitter like 2 days ago from Clips That Go Hard.
Clips That Go Hard. Yeah.
And the caption was just people jumping out of the Twin Towers on 9/11.
It's so loud when they come. It's terrifying.
I blocked all those accounts. Yeah. I don't need to see that shit.
I never watched that one.
Which one?
I saw the description of it. The jumpers. It's from the ground, of like firefighters.
It's just people autoplay. Jumping.
Is it audio,
Twitter,
yeah.
Like,
audio too?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's loud. It sounds like a fucking
terrible,
car accident.
Dude. Oh, sounds terrible.
Yeah, having a jump would...
They didn't say it was so high up, though, you could like die before you even hit the ground.
Yeah, which can't, it's just not true.
You don't think so?
No.
You don't think you would like suffocate?
No. Not people me. Skydive.
That is, yeah, that is definitely true.
Do you think people like caught the plane? Like how many people do you think, yeah. Like, as it was like coming into the building? Like, do you think there were like
100%.
How many people do
I mean,
you think
people got
that?
Hit by it, yeah.
Yeah, like how many?
It also,
like, it also was like probably died, just, like, it's so fast and it's just a huge explosion immediately.
Dying in an office job from the, like, you know, technically the most exciting thing ever too. There's a terrible thing about that. Just being so bored.
Yeah. God, nothing's ever going to happen. Oh, the most, the most important thing that's ever happened in modern America, in the world.
What time did the plane hit?
Early.
9:36? I don't know why I thought it was like 8:52.
It probably was around that time.
Something that adds up to 11. I've done the numbers.
You were just about to take a call.
I think the second one was 9:30. Maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah, it was pretty early. So remember, I remember being
8:46.
Yeah,
10 o'clock when they wheeled the TVs.
9:03.
God damn, that's coffee break time though.
They had to wait. There was like 15 minutes in between.
Yeah.
Damn.
Because the first one, they were like, maybe it was an accident.
Yeah, that's insane.
Second one, they're like, whoa.
Do you ever see a plane fly real low and you're like, it's going
to crash? Think about it every single time.
Like, oh, fuck.
We're right next to fucking LaGuardia. I see planes coming low. I'm like, this is it.
Yeah. Just part. Is there a part of you deep down?
Kinship coffee.
Part of you deep down that's like, come on.
I want to see
one. I want to see what it looks like.
Yeah, but that's, of
just
course.
Just see an A380 just slam into a building.
Yeah.
For sure.
But that's just the worst part of you. You know.
Just a sick idea from your animal soul.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, if I see, when I'm looking at the World Trade Center from far away,
yeah,
and I'm like, that must have been
like
fucking
crossing the bridge. I think about
see.
Where people must have been when it happened.
Yeesh.
Like on the George Washington Bridge would have been insane.
Oh,
all that. What a truly tragic event.
Yeah,
but the guy testing out Spider-Man
is so funny.
Is funny. Just like, especially if somebody else saw him, just like,
yeah,
like, dude, did you just try? It's like, shut the fuck up. I'm trying anything. Parachute man would have been so sick,
dude.
Yeah,
a parachute man would have been.
You know they got parachutes up there now. If I was that high up, I'd have a parachute on me.
Absolutely, dude.
Wingsuit, something.
Yeah, wingsuit would be wild.
having never even tried the wingsuit. Like, bam, 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 bam. straight to another building, right in the Tower 7.
I'd land in the Hudson for sure. Just coast right in
and drown in your parachute.
True.
Got out of that burning. What's the second worst death? Ah, shit.
Yeah, but you have your survival knife. You go, oh,
definitely.
Cut that off.
Definitely. I have no doubt I'd be able to parachute into a body of water and cut it loose.
Did you guys see that dude that jumped off the or crashed his plane purposely?
Nah.
You didn't see this?
No.
YouTuber?
Yeah. You didn't see
why
this?
Why did the YouTuber crash?
I feel like you definitely
no,
seen
what
it.
Happened?
He was like, he tried to, this happened like 2 years ago.
Was that the guy
ago.
Who came and said, he said all that really funny shit while he was flying around? He was like, woo.
No, that was awesome. Was that in Massachusetts?
I think so. I don't know.
Yeah.
What was that?
Hijacked a plane. He was a dude that worked on like the runway and he hijacked a plane.
Oh, shit.
And he was just taking it for a spin. Yeah. And he's like, crashed. Yeah, I fucked up, guys.
I'm going to land this thing, but don't be mean.
Yeah. It actually got really depressing at the end.
Yeah. You got to negotiate from up there. You got to say, dude, I'll land it, but no charges. Agree? Yeah.
That's kind of like what he was doing. He was like, they were like the air control people were like, yo, you got to land it. And he was like, yeah, I'm gonna. He's like, I'm just taking it for like, he's like, I'm just taking it for a spin. And then he just sailed into a fucking island. It exploded.
Oh, he died.
Yeah. He crashed. Yes, dude. Yeah. He killed himself.
What a beast.
Yeah, it was. It was
just
really.
He was just out there. Yeah. He was like, you know what?
Yeah.
I'm done, dude.
I'm grabbing a plane. It's crazy. I'm done working.
He flew it so successfully. Like, he took it off and he was doing like barrel rolls and shit.
What?
In like a commercial plane. It was crazy.
Oh, that's such a funny fucking way to go.
Yeah.
It's nah. Like, come on down. Nah.
Yeah.
You guys doing like Top Gun flybys. So mean if I do that. I'm just going to park it right here.
Who was the, what was the guy who crashed?
Oh, there's a YouTuber who like made a video of his plane supposedly crashing, or like the engines broke or shut down. And then he was like, luckily I always fly with a parachute with me. And then he just jumped out of the plane. But there was like 7 GoPros set up, like all angles. And then yeah, they investigated. Clearly, they were like, you blatantly just jumped out of your plane.
And then there's just a plane crashing onto California, where yeah, the fuck he was, which is
what the fuck?
Pretty serious.
Yeah,
crime.
He's going to jail for sure. But I remember, like, he put the video out.
The video is funny.
How many yeah, views? Jumping out of his own videos? Plane.
Dude, he got like 100,000 views.
Oh, no.
Not worth it at all. At all.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
He hit the eject button?
He was on like a Cessna plane, like yeah, a small ass plane.
He just so opened scary, like a car door and yeah, fell out of a plane.
What?
Yeah, it's hilarious.
He didn't even fly out through the top?
No.
He just literally like opens a door and like rolls yeah, out of a moving plane.
And everyone was like, dude, no one just flies with a parachute with them. And he was like, luckily I've always got my parachute on me.
So he was just like, yeah, crazy. Or he was like, the engines are going, mayday, mayday. Yeah.
It was like, no, he was so calm. Because it was like, it was clearly not real. And he was not really great at acting it out. And he was just like, oh no, the engines are gone. And then like apparently, like all these people, and like they were all saying, they're like, he didn't try anything. He didn't even try to like reboot the engines.
Yeah.
It was like one engine stalled.
And he just happened to have a GoPro.
Time to jump out of the plane. Yeah.
Happened to have a GoPro on the wing.
Yeah.
To watch him jump out.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was kind of open and shut.
Yeah.
What did the plane hit? It hit like farmland?
It landed in like trees and like in mountains. And I think it was in California. Yeah.
You started a forest fire?
No.
But then he landed on the plane to like recover the footage. And then edited it all together and then uploaded it.
Pretty nasty. You should at least go to the White House after you get
started. Yeah.
That's
yeah,
pretty nasty.
Yeah.
To pilot your thing to your Cessna?
He was an Olympian. He was an Olympian?
Yeah. I just looked it up. His name was like Trevor. Oh, fuck. Occlusive.
Matt, you're getting hydrated for the gymnasium today.
I am. I peed earlier. It was yellow.
We got to go a little slower this time.
I am. I'm chilling. Yeah. I've told you I'm dead right now.
Last week we went a little too hard.
I'm playground legend right
what
now,
you guys
dude.
Hit?
Oh, yeah. True.
I was playing basketball on Sunday, dude. I'm fried from that. Then I rollerbladed all day yesterday.
Yeah.
Rollerblading's awesome.
Rollerblading's so
footage
nasty,
is nice.
Dude. Dude, I'm getting more of it back.
Yeah.
Where did you go? Tennis court?
The rollerblade?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, right.
I'm not that kind of blader, bro.
Dude, rollerblading on a tennis court's the best.
True.
Smooth as fuck.
It's a very smooth surface.
Yeah.
I was doing grassy hills. It was pretty sick.
Oh, damn.
Yeah, it's pretty, I'm cross country. Dude, it was I'm filming a rollerblading intro for my special.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So I was like, I'll hop on the blades, get some footage. I got on it like we started at 10 o'clock, so I showed up at 9:40 to practice. Dude, I was so bad.
Yeah.
I'm rollerblading forever.
I'm sure. Who
dude,
has?
Stopping is the hardest part.
Unless you have the brake on the heel, dude.
Nah,
dude,
that shit takes does not forever. Work. Yeah. That shit does not work. You gotta drag your foot.
I would just like find grass and jump into it to stop.
Yeah, that's the best move. Yeah.
Dude,
that was
fun.
My favorite part is you jumping from the hill.
Dude, it was nonstop stabilization. Yeah. I would just all of a sudden like at
did
one
you go
point,
down Kensington?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Dude, that was so scary.
Of course.
I just drive heroin? Through it. I yeah. drive through it thinking like this is fucked up, but like I was like, yeah, I'll breeze through, we'll catch some footage. Terrified, dude.
I'd love to see security footage of you like fully sprinting on the rollerblades.
There is that footage exists, yeah. dude. I went through the intersection. Life. Well, you get up there and it's kind of like you see these people are like genuinely suffering. So I was like, I don't want to be like close ups of anyone's faces. So yeah. I wanted like a nice wide through. I was on Allegheny going through Kensington Ave, like cutting across Kensington Avenue. Dude, the first time we tried it, we got we got stuck at a red light. So I was standing outside of rollerblades, like
holy shit.
And a dude ran up behind me and went, and I was like, oh no. Scared the shit out of me, dude.
It is a haunted house, dude.
Dude, it was so spooky. And then And then I go, all right, let's go around. We got it. We'll time the light. Let's do it again. So we spin the blocks. The first time was kind of like whatever. And this dude's in a trunk, Mike Gallagher. Yeah. I mean, basically covered a war zone, dude, in a trunk with a fucking really, probably a really expensive camera. And we go around for the second time. And it's, I was like, all right, as soon as that light turns green, we'll go. So we start going. The light just turns red real quick again. I'm at the second time like, oh, fuck. So then we did get it, because then afterwards the light turned green. I got like a little shot of like, I had a hop up on him, and they were like, go in the turning lane, we'll go in the other lane and come back and meet us. So I went to the turning lane and got blocked by cars. So I had to like hop up on a median. It was either like jump up and skate through the bros,
yeah,
or hop up on the median, dude. And then they have
the bros would get you.
I'm making my way back to the car. They have footage. I'm like, like genuinely scared. It was scary, dude.
Yeah, that's gonna be.
You do any sketching?
I did a little sketching, yeah.
That's awesome.
What's sketching?
Just like holding on the back of the car. I had to sometimes. Yeah. I was filming and it was being shot from a trunk.
Yeah.
So I'd be rolling, if we'd stop, I'd come up to stop myself. I used the car constantly. Like,
yeah,
Just nail the car. It was so fun.
That dude. The one you sent me where it fades to the city. That's got to be the intro. That's got to be the.
That'll be the end of the intro.
The title.
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was pretty.
You think
sick
of a title yet?
Yeah, I'm still thinking. I'm getting closer and closer.
All right.
I'm getting closer and closer. I think I've stumbled upon a eureka on the way up here. I went, eureka. That could be it.
What do you think?
Speed of light.
Speed of light.
Hell yeah.
Fuck yeah.
That's awesome.
We'll see. Yeah, that was fun. I played pickup basketball, fried myself to the point where I thought I was going to have to go to the ER. And then I didn't think of that, but I was.
Yeah, you told me you thought you were dying.
Well, what happened was I went to swallow. And I was so parched that I couldn't swallow. So the time that I didn't swallow, I was like, I should probably be breathing instead of swallowing. And I was like, it took me a second to switch gears, dude. I was like, oh God, here it comes.
I'm having a stroke.
Yeah, that was fine. But yeah, dude, I played in a senior citizen basketball 1-on-1, 69 years old.
Really?
Yeah, he was nice. He was fucking
good. It was a draw.
It was a draw.
You guys tied?
Although we were, I wasn't going super hard on him too.
Yeah.
So we hit 4-4. I honestly think he was up. I think it was 3-4. He messed up the score and I was like, man, maybe I did score another point. I don't know. So we got to 4-4 and he goes, it's a tie, bro. The whole dude went right to my head. I blocked one of his shots. He goes, you must be 75% black, bro. What the hell? It was so funny.
Oh, damn.
I was playing the bros, dude.
Damn.
I was the only white boy on the court, bro.
That's a good compliment.
Yeah, it was funny. It was just all of his old friends watching. It was nonstop. Ah,
really?
So fun.
Oh, fuck.
And I played a whippersnapper after that, man. He was such a punk, dude. As soon as he started losing, he started doing that shit where he'd watch the other court and just be like, yeah, I guess you're shooting mid-range. That's fucking corny, bro. You can hit those all day. And it's like, all right, dude. And I drove past him and it was just like, I could do that every time. But I was,
yeah.
Yeah, it's like, dude, please. Yeah, it was fun.
How does that work? Punk. You just show up to the court?
Showed up to the court, yeah.
Damn.
Yeah, where my house is, there's a small lot where it's just all old black dudes that hang out. I always like say what's up to them. And they were like, we're playing basketball over there. So I was like, nice. I would love to come dominate these dudes. All old men just come and just slam on them.
So it was just you and a bunch of old black dudes?
That's what I was hoping for. When I show up and they all started playing softball, I missed the basketball. So I was just shooting around. And this old guy was like, softball would have been nasty. And this old guy was like, let's play 1-on-1. So we started playing. He was the funniest dude in the world. He goes, damn, you jump. I can't jump high at all. My boys couldn't jump. It was so funny. He said my handle was so. Man, his handle's unbelievable.
Oh, that's nice.
Right to my head.
What's a better compliment than a black guy on a basketball court?
Dude, so now I got playground legend status. I walk past all the old word travel to the old black dudes in the park.
What do you think your nickname is?
White
on the
boy
court?
For sure.
Fat butt, dude.
Fat butt.
Fat butt. No, I have no idea.
That should be your name of your special, Fat Butt.
Fat Butt would be nice. But yeah, dude, it was playing b-ball was so fucking fun. And then I went right from there to rollerblading. I was shattered, dude. My fucking I'm chafed up right here. Where I was laying in bed with Brittany, and she's fucking her feet. She's always rubbing them on me when she's going to sleep. She rubbed where my rollerblade I got irritated from my rollerblade. I literally went, it's irritated from my rollerblade. I didn't know. I was like, you couldn't have known, but it just hurt. That's all. I didn't say you did anything wrong. I didn't see her do anything wrong. I'm just saying it's tender there right now. And you fucking pushed it.
I'm trying to go to sleep.
I should never get pussy ever again. I'm going, that's where my tender for my rollerblades.
Rollerblading is awesome. I threw on some rollerblades recently.
It's so nasty, dude.
It's really? Fun.
Yeah. I might start doing it more.
In our office.
Oh.
At the Barstool office.
How about that?
Did a little lap around the office.
You got the fastest time?
Yeah.
What'd the girls say? They were noticing.
What did all those beautiful barstool girls say?
They said, that's very impressive. They said, I bet your shins are very tender right now, so I won't touch them. They respected me.
That's a good woman, dude.
Yeah, they behave themselves over there.
Yeah, the hosts of Dirty Slut Hour are very good. They're very good girls.
We got to break into that space.
I know.
Dirty Slut Hour?
Yeah.
I really
or,
do.
Or, yeah, man, Chad Slut Hour, where it's just like...
But it's just the one dude?
Yeah, where it's just like... You don't understand this about being a guy.
Yeah.
It's like, wow.
Men are hunters.
Yeah.
We hunt for pussy. It's deep in our DNA.
Yeah, I've never thought about it like that.
Yeah.
Those podcasts are fucking insane.
They're the best.
They're insane.
They're wild. You watch them? I actually got a DM from a dude. I got a DM from a dude who hit me up.
Let me tell you something. The first thing I did with that, straight to my penis.
What is that thing? What is that thing?
It's one of those massagers, Theraguns.
Oh, nice.
I literally used that on my penis, but yes, you can touch it.
Like, till you busted?
No.
Oh, come here. Give me that thing. Who cares? You hit my back for a second, brother?
It's so nice.
My back's fried.
That was from Bert.
Is it really?
Yeah.
It's not working. Oh.
Hey, let me see. I'll get you back.
Ah! Oh, my God, dude.
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah, it's awesome. Ah, work that out in a minute. That's nice, dude.
You gotta just hold it down.
There we go.
Yeah. That thing, I would never use it again, though, because the short time it was on my penis, I realized we might be onto something here.
I put one on my penis, and it didn't feel good. It just hurt.
Yeah, that's like really? A puncher,
it was just
dude.
Hurting my balls. Yeah, it was smacking my balls
around.
Well,
if I put it on my nuts, yes, that would hurt.
That
would really, really hurt.
Use it for ball torture? Fuck.
No, you put a Theragun on the... tip of your penis?
Yeah.
You're going to jizz.
Yeah, I can see
really?
That.
Really?
Yeah.
Why did you not jizz?
Because somebody jizz. Was here.
Oh, okay.
I was just kind of... I'm going to do that the second I get to be alone, dude. Can't wait.
You can put it in your pocket and just fap. Yeah. Just have it going in your pocket.
Yeah. It's pretty quiet, too. Yeah, you could go stealth mode.
No, that thing's loud as hell.
Stealth
jerk. Trust me,
off.
I was trying to put it on my penis while...
Yeah.
A woman was here,
true.
Laying.
Have you ever tried the forbidden fap?
Yeah.
While a lady's sleeping next to you and you try to go real quiet.
I've never gone for it, honestly.
Oh, I've forbidden fapped in some bad places as a young boy.
Did you really?
In like when I was like really young.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
It's like 4 years ago. You're a young boy now, dude.
When
how
I was
young?
Like
we're
when I was
seventh
like,
grade.
Yeah, like seventh, eighth grade.
A fap on the dance floor would be nice. Fapping on a dance floor.
It was like you had to. There was no other option. You had to jerk off. It was like, I don't think I'll survive if I don't.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had those. I've had those before.
Forbidden faps. No, I've tried it before. My wife are just fucking like, I think she'll notice. Yeah. Tried to do a quiet fap.
Yeah.
What are you doing? Like, nothing.
Nothing.
I wasn't
sleep.
Going for the forbidden fap. I've never completed the forbidden fap, though.
You've never been able to nut?
I've always stormed my quarters, dude.
Yeah.
The bathroom.
You head to the quarters.
I must take it to the bathroom. The forbidden fap has been foiled. I must go to the west quarters. It's 1 o'clock in the morning. I'm grabbing my phone, Ed headphones. Yeah. Where are you going? I'm like, I'm taking a shit. Yeah. Oh, I just have to shit.
Full boner getting up.
I'd be laying next to her for an hour just fucking.
Oh, I just woke up. I have to shit.
I remember being in middle school in class being like, I have to masturbate now. And then I'd get up to go to the bathroom. And then I'd get up and I'd have a massive boner and instantly I'd be like, what the fuck am I doing, dude? And then I would just go back
and
to class.
Then you'd go back to the kitchen where your mom was teaching. You were definitely homeschooled, dude.
I was not homeschooled.
All right, quick. What middle school did you go to?
Don't worry about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, right. Yeah, right. You don't even know. You're absolutely homeschooled.
I was not homeschooled. Let me show you my yearbook photo.
Please.
I actually can't. I have no idea how I'd find that. It's a Christmas card.
Oh, fuck, dude. I forgot all about that.
What an insane thing to say. That's like, that has to be like the best, like, slight insult. Just ask someone if they're homeschooled.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
No, I don't know a single person who's normal who is homeschooled. Except me. You. You were homeschooled. Normal guy.
I was homeschooled, obviously.
Ah, you fucking asshole.
The captain of the football team.
Yeah.
Homeschooled. I was in the backyard running drills.
He walked on.
My dad
he
was like, someday you could be a captain if you keep doing this. Doing ladder drills in the backyard. Hitting the sled.
Yeah, it's so sick. There's hitting nothing the sled better rules. Than the
dude,
sled
I see
bros,
sleds.
Dude.
I'm like, oh my God, I wish. Although that was like kind of the shittiest part of practice.
The sled?
Sled was shitty.
You could also fake lift on the sled, though.
Yeah, but then I was tackle, so you could really tell
which it was hard to
who was pushing.
Yeah, as a guard, you'd be comfortably in there to fucking
center. You're fucking chilling.
Chilling, yeah.
Yeah.
That is true. They start spinning. Yeah, you can't
start spinning a little. The coach who's riding it's like, come on.
Oh, that makes sense, yeah.
What are you, gay? Like, I'm fucking 16. You fucking drunk? You weird drunk? We were talking about just dudes, high school, like in high school, like dudes will like grab you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like a coach will be like, now, come on, hit me. You can hit me for real. It's not going to hurt. Like, while you're holding like the shield, you know, that like pad, he'd be like, now you get under it and you fucking drive up. Jesus, coach. We had a coach.
They all did that.
Yeah, they
hold,
every single
hold
one.
It,
I'll show you. Yeah. You're like, this hurts. We had a freshman coach that challenged our running back to like a one-on-one drill. And he was obviously not wearing pads.
Yeah.
And he got cracked in his face with a helmet.
Oh.
He was like,
oh.
Just blood. It was wonderful.
We probably loved it, dude.
Oh, it was sick.
We had a high school baseball coach who was like playing catcher, like in practice, got hit right in the arm like exploded.
Really?
Shattered.
You were a high school baseball player.
No, just got made its way around
watching.
The town.
Oh, you're just watching from your window. From your bedroom.
Here's all the chain link. Yeah.
One day I'll be a real boy. One day I'll play baseball.
Baseball.
Got home.
Like, Mama.
Mom, what's baseball? Baseball is the devil. I invented baseball. Oh, man. Little Sass man.
The best, dude.
You didn't play baseball? You struck me as a baseball kid.
I played like youth baseball.
Yeah.
Never high school.
Do you play any high school sports?
Through Jav for a season.
Through Jav, dude.
Yeah.
That's nice. Really?
Yeah, Jav was awesome. Well, yeah,
how far were you tossing that thing?
Not far. It was not. We weren't like a serious team.
Okay.
It was just like track was. There was no tryout, so you would just sign up.
Track
and field. I threw jab for a bit. Threw shot put. No, I didn't throw shot put. I threw disc a couple times.
Disc is nasty.
Disc is awesome.
Yeah, that's pretty sick.
Disc is cool.
I threw shot put because there was no other shot putter on my grade school track team, so I made it to like the area championship.
Yeah, that's exactly what would happen.
I got smashed, dude.
Yeah.
You're like, I'm the best shot put thrower on earth,
dude. I
there's like five
I
dudes that
thought
throw
I was
shot
Hercules.
Put.
I was the only dude. I was just tall, strong, fucking shot put.
Yeah.
You ever see that video of that guy getting racked in the nuts by a chick doing like the hammer throw?
No.
Pretty awesome.
Wait, they have
the guy standing next, like the judge standing directly next to her. It's the one where you like swing that.
Oh no!
Right? Isn't that the hammer?
Oh, that's not still.
She lets go like. Right here, it just goes straight into a guy's crotch.
I thought there was an event where ladies just throw hammers as far as they can. I was like, never seen.
Yeah, they don't even know what hammers are.
Hell no!
Like, what do you throw them? No, idiots.
Have you ever done axe throwing?
No,
never.
That's supposed to be crazy.
I have tried.
I always get scared because they said that it can bounce back.
I've seen videos.
Yeah, I've seen them where they come back and almost hit people.
I saw Lemaire hitting the axe throw. He was at the Dave and Buster's hitting the axe throw.
Yeah, at the D&B.
While you were fucking hitting the fucking Star Wars, he was.
Oh, you were axe throwing there?
He was on the axe.
How were you on the axe?
It was all right. It was pretty nice. I found the video of the lady hammer throwing the gym.
Hammer throwing straight to the dick?
Yeah. Oh.
It's pretty awesome,
yeah,
right?
It's pretty nice.
Guys getting hit in the nuts is hilarious. You ever see that fat guy get hit in the nuts in the opening pitch?
No.
Oh, man. They have like a. You know how they have like famous people do
the
opening pitch?
Yeah.
Somebody somebody just throws it. Terrible. There's just a fat photographer standing in the back, just straight into his nuts. Oh. Pretty wonderful.
I've seen the videos of the tennis dudes awesome. Getting the ball boys
getting hit,
smacked in the nuts, and then they have to like, for some reason, I don't know what their like rules are, but they have to like pretend like it medieval. Didn't happen.
What? Yeah. Tennis has like medieval rules.
Yeah,
of like you're not allowed to make noise. You have to sprint, get the ball, and then.
Yeah,
so he gets smacked in the nuts by like a ball going like 100 miles per hour, like, and then he just has to stand there and just eat it like nothing happened.
Fat guy getting hit, awesome. Unbelievably funny video.
God damn. Yeah, tennis is
I mean, he's fat and gets hit in the nuts, dude.
Yeah, that's kind of not. Fat guy's falling is another
fat
one.
Guy's just... fall, fat guy falling on a German Shepherd taking a shit on the sidewalk. Yeah. One of my favorite videos of all time. I tried to do that as like material. I remember we were at Ferg's. Isn't that what it was called? The upstairs place? Yeah. I was just sitting there like showing you and Blizz that video on repeat. And I was like, there's my material for the night.
Yep.
I got on stage. I was like, there's a fat guy. This German Shepherd takes a shit. People in Philly were like, this guy's next. This is unbelievable. He's describing YouTube videos again.
He's back down.
Yeah.
That is one of the funnier videos.
Fat guy falling, just his fat foot slides out on a giant pile of shit.
We were watching videos of dudes splitting their pants, but their dicks come out.
Too. Yeah, you see that one where the kid drops it low?
Yep.
Yeah, that's what we were. I was literally so just. Have you seen it?
Yeah, it was awesome.
And then who was the musician that did it? Oh, Lenny Kravitz.
Lenny Kravitz's dick popped out.
Yeah, you haven't seen this?
I don't know if
watch
I have.
Watch this one.
Let's see what Kravitz.
Let me get in there.
Let's see what Kravitz is working with.
Definitely a hammer.
God.
Ready?
What?
Dude, yeah. Dick's coming out on this.
That might be. You think that's the best your dick can be when you're fully crouched down?
Those dudes' dicks are huge for being completely soft.
Yeah, dude.
Especially when you're performing at a concert, he's got to be zero soft, like zero blood in his penis.
I would imagine there's not much.
And it's
although
still hanging.
You are looking at that whole front row being like, you will be mine.
Yeah, I could fuck any of you.
But no, I was pure hanging. Kravitz has the ham,
American
bro.
Woman. That fucking gay dude dancing when his pants.
Yeah, I have it right now. Cock. This one's so fucking funny.
Yeah, it was great. Hero. Yeah. That was hey,
massive dick. That's wild.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, what time is it?
Oh, yeah, shit.
We got to switch.
Yeah, let's jump.
You gotta switch over.
Let's jump.
Sass, thank you for joining us. I was actually just listening to Sass's recent podcast with Lemaire Lee.
Yeah.
Son of a boy dad, yeah, Lemaire Lee.
So I was listening to the one with Billy Spud, too.
Yeah, you guys really like our show.
Why, do we talk about it?
No, you just have all our guests.
Oh, yeah, I know.
The War Mode app was, I haven't seen Lemaire's one yet. I'm sure it's a treat.
It is.
I've seen half of the War Mode one. It's
War Mode's great.
Warm up was really fun. Those guys are great.
Lemaire episode's great too.
Lemaire was great.
Can't wait.
Coming
people
in
loved
confident.
Lemaire. People loved Lemaire.
Lemaire is so confident. Yeah. You guys should definitely hire Lemaire for at Barstool for gaming podcast would be big there. Plus, they need an African American hire.
They do.
You get and you were saying that all the big fight video game guys live in New York.
Yeah, they all live in New York.
You could bring them in, challenge them, get your ass beat every week.
My dream.
Just get dommed by fucking alpha nerds.
Yeah. Alpha Street Fighters players. Yeah,
dude, that's pretty.
You could call
idea.
It Street Fighters pizza rolls.
Street Fighters pizza rolls.
Get a plate of pizza rolls for every guest.
Dude, it's sponsored by Tostino's. Dude, come on.
Pitch it to the big guy.
Get him in touch with Portnoy.
Get him six figs.
Yeah, I will.
Dude, hell yeah.
So we found the perfect guy.
I'm sure they would do it.
Yeah, I think you could actually do it. You said it on the podcast, and I was sitting here playing MLB The Show, and I was like, we might be on to something. It's playing game 3 of the NLDS.
Yeah, if you go in with like a concept for a show, they would probably do it.
Not bad, dude.
They'll give it a test run, and you'll have viewers right away.
Yeah.
True.
Unlike most of them. But you know what else would help is a hot slut.
Ooh,
they sell tickets.
They'd come. You get one. You could
get one hot gaming slut. Ooh.
That's like a big streamer thing too. It's not. They don't even need to be gaming. They just sit in the side.
Yeah, make her smoke a cigarette the whole time too. Through a silk glove.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you had a hot lady smoking cigs the whole time, that'd be actually
big tits. Put her in like a nice dress.
Yeah.
Every week.
Dig up some old porn star. Yeah, it's more war torn porn star.
Okay.
All right.
I'll get on it.
Hurry up and do that because it's going to be successful.
Yeah.
I could watch you play video games
and lose.
That'd be pretty funny.
You'd get one, though.
Yeah.
You get one here every now and again. You could also fuck with the controls a little, too. It's your house.
Just cheat.
Put them on like super hard or yourself on easy and just fucking.
Yeah.
That would be actually really funny if you're cheating against like expert gamers and they're spazzing.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
You have to play blindfolded. You can't play straight up.
All right, let us do the ideas.
All right. Sass. Thank you, bro.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
What a treat to have you, buddy.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
You're welcome to stay if you want.
Yeah, we're going to do the
Patreon. All right, we're going to go to the Patreon. Thank you.